So joining me now is Art Del Cueto, Vice President of the National Border Patrol Council. Art, good to have you with us this evening. You know, what are your Border Patrol agents telling you about what they're facing right now there?
You know, it's the same thing we've always faced. We're out there apprehending the illegal aliens. We're out there apprehending the drug smugglers. That hasn't stopped. It's very frustrating for the agents right now, because we're seeing so many people in certain parts of the media that are portraying everything with their own agenda, I guess, their own agenda. And it's just false lies that they're out there projecting. And it's really upsetting for the agents.
Now, in terms of what they're being told to do, and I want to get more into the point that you just made in a minute. We're going to play a soundbite in a second from Cynthia Nixon. But in terms of what they're being told to do, are they referring people for prosecution? Are they putting people into these facilities so that, and they're going to be held until they go to a court? Or is this catch and release all over again?
Well, we are arresting the individuals like we always have.
Right.
We turn them over to another entity. They're the ones that take care of where they're going to be placed. But the problem that we are seeing with the unification again, and I mean, let's get this straight. We're not asking to be mean to these children. No one has been mean to the kids. I think the media is the one that was trying to portray us as the evil people or the Nazis, as they said, which I'm still disgusted by that word. But the reality is we have hardworking men and women out there. I myself was out there working since very early today. I came out here so I can do this show. And we have a very, very tough job. It's very difficult because it's frustrating because of the lies that are being portrayed. But the agents are upset, not upset, but they're confused, I would say, because if you don't have any consequences for these individuals, there's certain laws that prevent us from holding the individuals, the children, past 20 days. And I'm referring to Reno versus Flores, and we know the law exists. So when you can't detain him for a certain amount of time and you don't have enough judges, the problem will be that it will start catch and release all over again.
I completely understand what you're saying. You know, in terms of the way that some of the agents, both Border Patrol and ICE agents, are being portrayed, listen to this from former actress Cynthia Nixon, who's now running for mayor of New York City.
ICE has strayed so far from its mission. It's supposed to be here to keep Americans safe, but what it's turned into is frankly a terrorist organization of its own that is terrorizing people who are coming to this country.
She wants to be governor of New York, and she says that ICE is now a terrorist organization.
I mean, I don't even know what to say to these people anymore. You know, you guys were shown the facility where these children are being held. The pictures that the media likes to continuously show certain members of the media is pictures from the Obama administration. They refuse to admit that it's not this current administration. We have agents that are out there taking their own food, toys, you name it, to take care of these children that we're apprehending and to be portrayed by these people. And you know, some of these individuals that are putting on their Twitter pages and attacking agents, they're individuals that were out there, they grew up with a silver spoon. We have agents out here that they're hardworking American people that they're defending our country. That's what they're doing. They're defending our country. And to be portrayed as Nazis or to be attacked, you know, there was a Twitter that was sent out by Peter Fonda where he was saying that they need to come and terrorize our kids.
Yeah.
Terrorize, you know, at the schools, find out our addresses, terrorize us at home. Who does that? You know, he's asking for terrorizing, you know.
Not only the
United
former
States
director
kids.
Of the CIA, Michael Hayden, made a comparison to Nazi concentration camps where exterminations were done. It's unconscionable very difficult to understand.
It's
because
disgusting.
Thank you.
Is what it is. They need to go back to history class and, you know, redo history. They should have, they were probably sleeping during history class. They had nothing better to do, so they just went ahead and fell asleep and decided to pick up a real quick one-liner so they can make headlines and sell some books.
I know you're not getting a lot of sleep these days, Art, because you guys are very busy. And we thank you so much for making time for us tonight in the middle of all of this.